stroke cap round. I do this, it's gonna be. It didn't work. I wonder if that's a bug in processing that we just found. That stroke cap doesn't seem to work in P3D. Okay, so I have this Lorenz system.
And this is based on the coding challenge by Daniel Schiffman?
Yeah, this is a coding challenge.
And what is a Lorenz system?
Lorenz system this is based on an ordinary differential equation.
Oh, wow. So that's calculus again.
Oh, boy. So what is an ordinary differential equation? Come over to the whiteboard. Okay, so I'm on the whiteboard again. Now, is this the room one? I think it is not. Okay, now, the Lorenz system is a system that has so what is an ordinary differential equation? No, this is a terrible spring. Let's see, I have a spring. The bob on the bottom. And it had a position called Y.
Yeah.
What we need to calculate is dy over dt to calculate its velocity. This is also a chaotic system. What does chaotic mean? If you pull it over here, it's gonna bring back much more quickly than if you put it over here. This is the idea of a small change to the input makes a large change to the output. The reason why it's called the Lorenz attractor is actually the algorithm is invented by this person called Edward Lorenz.
It was a mathematician.
Edward Lorenz discovered these chaotic systems. Lorenz attractor is one of them. So the Lorenz attractor tractor. Choirs, three variables. It requires a position, which is a three-dimensional vector. A velocity, which is a three-dimensional vector. A whole bunch of constants. Or is a three-dimensional vector. Or there are actually really four variables. There is also a time scale.
And you use those for in the code. In the Java code that you just showed me.
And I actually called this just to be a little shorter. I called this just consts.
And you said that you changed something in the code? You did something not the way Daniel did it, but a little bit different?
Velocity was not a global variable. Dan actually used three separate variables to keep track of everything. So that's 10 variables. Ooh, that's a lot. Now I have only four. Okay, so I'm gonna pause for a second. You're gonna see the formulas.
Pisova. Okay. Ta-da! Here are the formulas.
So, this over here is the formula. So dx over dt, and I forgot the equal sign here. Okay, dx over dt equals sigma, which in the code you'll see it's consts dot x.
Mm-hmm.
Times y minus x, meaning that's the x. Y of the point minus the x of the point. Dy over dt equals x times rho, which you're going to see is constant y in the code. X times rho minus z minus y. And then dz over dt equals x times y minus beta, which you're going to see in the code is const dot z times z. And if you see x, y, and z, I really mean here, pause that x, pause that y, and pause that z.
And time?
Time, that's the time, that's the dt.
That's the okay. Alright. So that's the way you made it. And Daniel had more variables.
Yeah. I'm gonna make this rainbow color now.
Okay. I'm gonna stop this because your sister is getting...